The events of 2016 with the rise of populism in politics around the world create some quite interesting and serious questions for the accountancy profession. So before Brexit or Trump or these things came along, there was of course a question about how best do accountants provide information that people need. And this is particularly important with government. People don't want to pay their taxes and see their money wasted or frittered away with fraud and corruption or wasted on inefficiency. And so for governments around the world, having sound, strong, reliable information that the public can rely on is important, but equally important that the government itself knows that it's spending money wisely. And there are pressures on this already. Are we providing the right sort of information? Are we measuring the right sort of things? We'll measure our pension liabilities for the future, but should we, for example, consider societal ills, a failure to provide people with skills or a failure to provide people with good health as a liability that one day will cost the state just as much? Now, without getting into sort of technical questions about this, it's obviously very difficult to think about changing reporting arrangements to take into effect societal ills. But we do see change happening. Integrated reporting is a very important way forward of organisations telling their narrative and thinking about the effect that they have on the environment around them. The added difficulty, of course, for accountants in the public sector and in government is that on the one hand, you have to respect that there is a political mandate. People are elected, they say they're going to do things and they want to do them. Of course, the public also has an expectation that that isn't a blank check. It doesn't mean that they can do anything. And actually, the policies on which they've been elected should afford value for money and should be executed in as strong a way as possible. And this makes it difficult for accountants in government because on the one hand, you want to make sure that there's absolute certainty on value. On the other hand, you have to speak truth unto power and say, well, some of the ideas and some of the things that you've stood on election for don't quite make sense, or they don't add up if you do it in the way that you want. So accountants in the public sector have always needed a strong set of soft skills and a strong sense of ethical skills to build upon the technical skills that they already have. But I think along comes Trump, along comes Brexit, along comes populism. And this sort of undermines the confidence that we have about what we're doing, because in the Brexit campaign in the UK, for example, a leading politician said, we don't want to hear from experts. So while we think, actually, we want to provide expert information, you can trust us to give you assurance that the numbers or the accounts should be held in this way, populism says, but we don't like the look of you. You're part of the elite. You're the experts. We don't trust you. You don't listen to what we've got to say. And I think this is going to be something which we're going to have to deal with over the next year or two and think our way through. There are no easy solutions. But on the whole, I would say, let's really think about the quality of what we're providing. And if it's becoming too complex and too technical and loses sight of the purpose of why we're doing our job, we ought to challenge ourselves that it's getting out of control and that we have to put things in plain English in a way that people can understand. Are we measuring the right things? For people concerned in the Rust Belt or people concerned in the north of England about whether or not they're being left behind, we can tell them that the economy is thriving, and they think, well, no, it isn't. I'm not getting any benefit out of it. You're just getting benefit in London or Washington or New York. And we're going to have to think that through, and we're going to have to think about are we measuring the right things? And thirdly, we've got to create trust in the profession. And issues such as taxation that sometimes make us look like the bad guys, we have got to work through. I don't think we're ever going to be a profession which puts up our hands and says, yep, we're not experts. You know, you trust us because we don't know what we're talking about. We're not experts. That's never going to happen, is it? We're going to be trusted and we want to give assurance. But perhaps what 2016 tells us is that we shouldn't have as much confidence as we have, that at the moment we've got a winning formula. Let's think about it and let's change.